Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you loop antenna with great clarity. Before I start with explanation, let me show you how many things that I'm going to cover in this video. See, first of all, I'll be discussing about basics of loop antenna. After that, I'll explain you how loop antennas are commercialized in market. After that, I'll explain you types of loop antenna, in which I'll explain you small loop antenna with its properties and large loop antenna with its properties. And at last, I'll be discussing about applications of loop antenna. So let us initiate this video with first agenda, that is basics of loop antenna. Loop antenna is a conductor in a loop. So if you have single wire and if you form a loop over here, then that will be simply loop antenna. Right, so you can observe here, see, we have rectangular loop over here, we have circular loop over here, we have triangular loop over here, and here we have octagonal loop. So we are having single wire only, but that we are forming in a shape of loop. Right, so it is a conductor in a loop. It can be formed using single wire in a different shapes and few shapes that I have shown over here. Right. See, loop antennas can be oriented horizontally, vertically, or in various configurations. I'll show you how it can be oriented in practical applications. See, loop antennas are popular because of their simplicity, compactness, and effectiveness. See, with loop antenna, there are varieties of applications. There are few loop antennas, those are large in size. Those are operated at lower frequencies. And there are few loop antennas, those are very compact, that we use it in very compact applications like RFID, like in NFC, right? I'll show you that even, right? So loop antennas are popular because of its simplicity, compactness, and effectiveness, especially for receiving signals at HF, VLF, and LF. See, feeding of loop antenna is quite simple. One can feed it using coaxial cable, where one terminal that we connect it with, one terminal of loop, and second terminal that will be connecting it with ground. Let me show it to you. See, here if I say we have coaxial cable, right? And this is what outer conductor of coaxial cable. So outer conductor of coaxial cable that we need to solder over here, right? Let us say this is ground over here. And if you say we have inner conductor over here, right? So inner conductor that we connect it over here. So that is what terminal that one can say. So that is how one can connect supply to loop antenna, right? So one should know, see, there are two terminals only, right? One is connected with phase, and second is connected with ground. That is how basic connection is there. Now I'll show you some applications of loop antenna. You can observe here we have large circular loop, right? And this loop antenna that we have made for HF frequency communication. Here you can observe we have multi circular loop that is mounted on a car. For AM reception, this loop is connected over here. Here also we have loop antenna, you can observe that is circular loop, and this circular loop that is utilized for 250 megahertz of frequency communication, right? Here you can observe octagonal loop is there, here you can observe another circular loop is there, and I told you like there can be multiple aspects of loop antenna. See, on PCB, multi-loop that is interfaced over here. And this is what PCB communication with NFC, and that communication is happening via loop antenna, right? So on PCB also loop antenna can be integrated, right? Now let us talk about types of loop antenna. See, here basically we have two types of loop antennas, small loop and large loop. See, with small loop antenna, length of the loop that will be lower than lambda by 10. If length of the loop is lower than lambda by 10, then one can say it is small loop antenna. Right. Here usually you will be observing that loop will be having multiple rounds. Right. So here if you have n number of turns, then in total length will be n into 2 pi r. See here r is radius. If you have r, that is radius, then circumference for one circle, that is 2 pi r into n, that is total length. So 2 pi r, that is circumference for one circle, into n, that is total length of this loop, that should be lower than lambda by 10. Let me show one practical application that will give you more clarity. Here you can observe on PCB loop is there, where here we have multiple rounds over here. We have multiple rounds over here in a loop, right? And this is what practical application of small loop antenna, where with this particular PCB, length of loop antenna is lambda by 5. So you can say this is what small loop antenna, and this type of small loop antenna that we use it for high frequency communication, like in NFC, in RFID, we use small loop antennas like this, right? If you talk about properties, then one should know null is appearing at perpendicular to the plane of the loop. So here null is appearing at perpendicular to the plane of loop. Let me show you how. See here we have top view, you can observe top view of loop. And if you watch it from side view, it will be appearing somewhat like this. So this is what plane of loop that one can say. And perpendicular to plane means this is the direction. So perpendicular to plane, null is appearing, means its radiation pattern that will be looking somewhat like this, you can observe. So null is appearing perpendicular to the plane of loop. It is having lower radiation resistance, and because of it is having lower radiation resistance, but obviously radiation efficiency will be also lower. Why? The reason is radiation efficiency depends on radiation resistance. One should know the basic equation. See, radiation efficiency, that is radiation resistance divided by radiation resistance plus loss resistance. And if you want this in terms of percentage, then multiply 100 over here. So if you have higher radiation resistance, you will be having higher radiation efficiency, right? Because of small loop antenna is having lower radiation resistance, its radiation efficiency is also lower, right? One more thing that you need to understand in terms of property of small loop antenna. See, if you have rectangular loop or if you have small loop, you need to understand resistance in terms of area. Like you see here, we have rectangular loop, and with this rectangular loop, let us say this dimension is D1 and this dimension, that is D2. So what is area over here? Area A1, that will be D1 into D2. And as if I say here we have radius R. So what will be area of this circular loop? Area will be pi R square, right? And as if A1 is equals to A2, you will be observing radiation resistance and radiation characteristics of both of this loop, that will be same. And that is what the case which is there with small loop antenna, right? It is not depending on shape, right? It is depending on area over here. That is what the basic property that one should understand, right? Now I'll be discussing about large loop. See, if overall length of loop is lambda, then you can say it is large loop, right? And with large loop, see, radiation is happening as per radiates at perpendicular to the plane of loop. So here you see we have perpendicular to the plane of loop. If you say this is my loop, side view is this, then this is what plane of loop. So radiation is happening perpendicular to the plane of loop. Means this is what perpendicular direction where radiation will be happening like this, you can observe, right? It is happening somewhat like this. See, relatively it is having higher radiation resistance, and as it is having higher radiation resistance, we have higher radiation efficiency as well. The reason is radiation efficiency, that is depending on radiation resistance. Large loop is having higher radiation resistance, that's why it is having higher radiation efficiency, right? So that is how all the basics are there with small loop and large loop. Now let us talk about applications of loop. See, there are many applications with loop antenna. As I have told you, we use it with varieties of frequencies, like we use it with AM and we also use it with very high frequency as well. So range of frequencies are there in HF, VHF, UHF as well as microwave frequencies. And see, at HF you will be having large loops only, right? And usually all these applications that is having lower gain application, remember this, loop antenna, that we use it with low gain applications, right? There can be applications based on AM radio reception, shortwave radio reception, direction finding. We also use it in RFID. We also use it in NFC. I have shown that in one diagram as well. You see, this is what NFC card, that is there with PCB, in which here we have loop, right? So in RFID, in NFC, we use loop antenna, that is there in these microwave frequencies. In wireless communication system as well as in inductive coupling, we also use loop antennas. So that is how loop antennas are commercialized in the market. I hope you have enjoyed this session. Still, if anything that you'd like to share, just note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.